The much anticipated moment is finally here. Comet 12P Pons-Brooks, called the Devil Comet, is about to make its closest approach to Earth. Hi, my name is Tim from Cosmic Captures, and in this video, I'll explore the story behind Comet Pons-Brooks' ominous nickname and explain why its fast journey around the Sun is something we should look forward to and not fear. I'll discuss the challenges of photographing comets and how I captured this celestial wanderer. I'll also offer tips for creating stunning comet photos, and you'll get to see what the comet really looks like. Stay tuned until the end when I'll share why this comet's visit offers an incredible once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for astrophotography. But before I discuss photography techniques, let's explore the mystery surrounding Comet Pons-Brooks. Comet 12P Pons-Brooks is a short periodic comet that orbits the Sun every 71.2 years. Its nucleus is larger than Mount Everest and bigger than average comets, making this occasional visitor one of the brightest known periodic comets. But does that make the comet dangerous? And what's up with this devilish nickname? In July 2023, Comet Pons-Brooks had a gas outburst that created a horn silhouette and ignited a media frenzy. But despite all the excitement, it poses no danger to Earth, remaining at least 1.5 astronomical units away, farther than 1.5 times our distance from the Sun. Right now, the comet is getting brighter and brighter, making it almost visible to the naked eye from a dark sky location. We can already capture its beauty with a camera, but getting a detailed and sharp image can be more challenging than you might think. Comets, especially their tail, are faint. So we photograph them using the same techniques as for deep sky objects. We aim to collect as much light as possible by taking multiple long exposures. But that type of astrophotography is a bit like taking photos from a spinning merry-go-round. Luckily, the Earth's rotation is predictable, and we can easily compensate for that movement with a tracking mount. However, a comet introduces an extra layer of complexity with its unique and independent motion. This makes it much more complicated to get a sharp image of the stars and the comet simultaneously. We can either track the stars, which causes the comet to blur, or we can track the comet, which causes the stars to streak. Additionally, optimal imaging times are limited, as comets only get bright enough when they're close to the Sun. That means that they're often low on the horizon, making it more challenging to image the comet under good conditions. Okay, so now we know the challenges. But what does that mean for the astrophotography gear we would need to capture Comet Pons-Brooks? Right now, the comet is large enough to be captured with an interchangeable lens camera equipped with a short telephoto lens on a tracking mount. This is the best gear if you want to include other deep sky objects and landscapes in the same field of view. With my astrophotography gear, I went for a more zoomed-in view of the comet. In Sweden, where I live, I used a small refractor with a 275 mm focal length and a cooled astro camera with a color sensor. To get a good image, I had to leave my backyard and travel to the countryside, where the sky was darker and the horizon less obstructed. In total, I managed to collect 91-minute exposures before the comet disappeared behind the trees. I also have access to a remote 4-inch refractor in Spain, less affected by light pollution. This setup has a mono camera, and I have to use red, green, blue, and clear filters for color and luminance details. With this telescope, I could capture the comet during 6 evenings. and I collected light for roughly 1 hour on each of them, with sub-exposures of 30 or 60 seconds. Both telescopes sat on equatorial tracking mounts, and I used auto-guiding to track the stars in each image. However, tracking the stars meant that the comet would be blurred in the final stacked image. So, how did I deal with that? What if I told you that there's a trick to capturing the stars and the comet in sharp detail? Stay tuned to uncover how you can do it. In modern astrophotography image editing, we can do amazing things. And this is especially true for comet image processing. What was impossible or very difficult with traditional techniques is now just a matter of choosing the right workflow. And at the core of it is our ability to separate the stars from the comet. This way, we can process both individually and recombine them into a final sharp image. Now, a little bit of a nerd alert, because I'm sure that not all of you will understand what I will be describing, but shortly after this section, there will be a part where I show you the images. So this is how I did it. I first calibrated and aligned each sub-exposure for consistent star placement, resulting in fixed stars, but a moving comet. Using PixInsight's comet alignment tool, I aligned all the frames to a reference frame. Mark the comet's nucleus in the first and the last frames. And this process created comet-aligned frames with moving stars in the background. With RC Astro's Star Exterminator plugin, I removed the stars from all of these frames and then stacked them into a high-quality comet image, which I saved as a 16-bit TIFF. Similarly, I stacked and processed the star-aligned frames, isolated the stars, and saved that picture as a separate TIFF. The final step involved compositing these two images in Photoshop for a complete picture. I know this is a quite advanced and time-consuming workflow, and it took me quite a while to get the hang of it, but in my opinion, the results speak for themselves. So let's look at them. This first picture is from November 2023. I didn't photograph the comet then, but Telescope Live did. And it's cool that I can get the data from them to show you how the comet's appearance dramatically changed over time. And that is precisely what I love about comet photography. They will never look the same again. And we have the unique opportunity to capture them like they are right now only once. And speaking of unique opportunities, comet Pons-Brooks aligns with the April 8 total solar eclipse over North America, promising a rare dual show, an eclipse and possibly a comet visible in daylight. Even if not visible to the naked eye, photographing this event could be a once-in-a-lifetime chance. But now to you. Have you ever photographed a comet? And if yes, how was your experience? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments. I hope that this video ignited your passion for comet chasing and the broader world of astrophotography. For more insights into capturing our beautiful cosmos, consider watching this video for a guide to other fascinating astrophotography adventures. Until next time, clear skies and good luck with your comet photography.